Let me ask you a question. Do you remember what triggered the Ladakh standoff earlier this year? It was China's fear of India's strategic construction. India is constructing roads and airstrips on the Indian side of the LAC, the line of actual control. But it's too much for China to digest. So in the month of May, around 100 tents sprung up on the Chinese side of the Galwan Valley. Back then, the Chinese Foreign Ministry said, and I quote, China is committed to safeguarding the security of its national territorial sovereignty, as well as safeguarding peace and stability in the China-India border areas. A skirmish in June led to the death of 20 Indian soldiers. China lost more men, but never released the numbers. In the months that followed, India took control of strategic heights. China fired shots in Ladakh, but made no gains. There is a stalemate in Ladakh. And the reason I'm telling you about all of this is because 6 months into the standoff, China is doing what it protested. China is constructing along the line of actual control. Chinese President Xi Jinping has asked his men to advance the construction of a rail line in Tibet. The line is 1,000 kilometers long. It connects the Chinese province of Sichuan to Lhinze in Tibet. It costs around $47.8 billion and reduces the 48-hour travel time to 13 hours. This railway line is also very close to the Indian state of Arunachal Pradesh, a state that China claims as its own and calls South Tibet. Speaking on Sunday, Xi Jinping said that the rail line will consolidate China's border stability. What he didn't say is that the line will also tighten Chinese control over Tibet and be crucial in troop mobilization. Now, should you and I bother about this rail construction in China? There are two ways of looking at it. First, through the Chinese lens, one that views every border construction as a provocation, one that viewed the construction of the 255-kilometer-long Darbuk-Shayok-Daulatbek-Oldi Road as a threat. Going by that logic, India too should protest this construction near Arunachal Pradesh. India should also protest the construction of a bridge over the Yarlung Zangbo River in the Tibet Autonomous Region and all the other border constructions that China has carried out over the years. But India respects international law. India understands sovereignty. It is another story that China does not. Sovereignty is too complex an idea for Beijing. China does not even understand military discipline. In a video recently released by the Global Times, Chinese soldiers were seen applying sunscreen and lip balm. The Chinese mouthpiece said that before heading to patrol, Chinese soldiers apply sunscreen and lip balm, and it makes them look, quote-unquote, cute. The Global Times goes on to say that with all the skincare experience, Chinese soldiers can now provide good recommendations. Take a look at this video. Chinese soldiers or skin care influencers, you decide. Thank you for watching Gravitas on Rion's YouTube channel. If you want to stay up to date with what's happening around the world, then subscribe to our channel and don't forget to like and share. Thank you very much for watching. Rion, World is One.